clothes on the schoolhouse.
I thought for sure that basket gun slinger was gonna save the day.
No, Rob Hood got put in jail for robbing from the railroad tycoon and giving the money back to the farmers.
What do you say to that, Madam Mary?
Would you like us to hold our horses 1 second? Hold your horses 1 second. I see someone taking aim at this here target.
But he can't win. There's already a bullet smack dab in the middle of the bullseye.
Why, he shot the other bullet in half. No, not quite yet. Why, he shot the other bullet in half. Look, it's Rob Hood. I wonder what face belongs to those lips alone to kiss.
This face.
Why, you're Alan Dale, that friendly lawman from the East I was so crazy about. I thought you were all done with us.
Not when I finally found myself a home, a place where I belong, keeping company with the people I care most about.
You came to us a stranger, rid this place of crime, and you gave us new hope in ourselves. It's gonna be one tough act to follow.
Well, how's this? Will you be my lawful wedded wife, Miss Nancy?
Oh, yes, I will!
Other people's dreams. I mean, what? not kind the man who'd take a job like that.
What kind of slob would take a job like that? Who could be mean enough, base and obscene enough, to take a job like that?
Wait a minute, here's something in the Herald that might be good.
Formerly married composer and lyricist Aaron Fox and Georgia Hendrix have invited film star Jessica Cranshaw with a star, people! That ought to be driven off a cliff.
What kind of mom would raise her boy like that?
Who'd want her baby to destroy like that?
Who could be jerk enough, hard up for work enough, to want a job like that? Oh, what kind of low-down, dirty bum?
What kind of man would want a job like that?
What kind of pots would make you nuts like that? Who could be thick enough, mentally sick enough? Who'd want to grow to be
everyone's enemy? Critics are hated and so excoriated. Tell me what kind of man.
Experience of the veterans involved, Robin Hood is sure to be a huge Broadway. Way to go.
Smash!
What kind of genius has a mind like that? So perspicacious, wise and kind like that. Far from his mother's knee, she must be thrilled to see how he grew up to be such brilliant company, refined and reflected, with completely objective loyal lifts of your heart to meet a man like that.
Jessica fainting?
Because she fainted during the bows when the critics dash out of the theater to dash off their postmortems. Face it, we've gotten our notices, and we've been given notice.
I'm afraid you're right.
No, you two are just oversensitive because you wrote the show. This is only round one. The first musical my husband and I produced was ravaged out of town. But we rolled up our sleeves, did a major rewrite, and brought it to Broadway. And that musical, my friends, was Kiss Me, I'm Irish. Closed before the audience opened their playbills. But the point is, this is a Sidney and Harmon Bernstein production. We decided it goes to New York, not Daryl Grady of the Boston Globe.
So we're still shooting for Broadway?
Aaron, Georgia, you keep writing tunes that bounce. Oscar, you keep writing checks that don't.
Very nice, but until our leading lady gets out of the hospital, who knows what happens next?
We just have her under observation. I'm sure she'll be out by the morning.
Is there no limit?
Our director.
Is there no limit?
That's such a limit.
Is there no limit, I ask you, to my unbridled brilliance?
Chris, where the hell were you tonight? I put a lot of money into the show as our director. You owe all of us.
Be still, your foolish mouth.
Nothing to be gleaned by watching one's own show with the fraudulent audience of Notley Night. Went for a walk past the Cathedral of the Holy Cross. Went in wildly spiritual. I tell you, those Catholics really know how to put on a show. And right there, in the middle of the Eucharist, I had an epiphany. At this stage in the life of any musical, one should refrain from inventing anything brilliant, but simply eliminate all that is god-awful
And what, I ask, without fear of contradiction, was the most god-awful thing about our show?
Jessica!
No, of course. Carmen, I came here to ask you to get rid of our star, only to have the cast inform me she's in the hospital. I see the hand of the Lord in this.
Mrs. Bernstein, there's a phone call for you in your office.
Thanks, Jenny. That's probably my husband calling.
And where was Sydney tonight, Carmen?
Sydney's in New York, booking a theater for us. And, knowing my husband, also booking a soprano, who can't dance but knows how to move.
At least she can joke about it.
It's easy to joke about marriage when men like Sydney and you don't take it seriously.
There's no comparison. I never did more than flirt with any woman in any cast once you and I got married.
Barbara O'Brien.
She was an usher, and that was after you moved out.
Oh, so you finally looked up from your music and noticed I was gone?
Jenny, you're the stage manager. How is the cast taking the reviews?
They decided to dress to the nines and throw a combination opening and closing night party.
Defeatist, the lot of you. You have yet to hear my plan of action, but hear it ye shall. Jenny, come help me watch you move the piano.
What plan? You think he wants to go to Broadway using an understudy?
Well, at least we'd still have Bobby in the title role.
And that's what matters, right? I mean, the whole reason you teamed up with me again was so you could rekindle the romance with our leading man.
Eric, when I signed up, I had no idea Bobby was even in this show.
Really? Then why at our very first rehearsal did you walk right up to him and say...
Hi, Bobby.
Hi, sweetie. Well, looks like we're all going to be heading back to New York a little sooner than we thought. But if you and I are coming back together, this is one flock that's a big hit with me.
Eh bien, mes enfants. A brief demonstration of what's been wrong with this show right from its very first love song.
Thinking of him, that's one of my best songs in the show.
One of our best songs?
See, Georgia agrees with me.
Nonetheless, I've had an issue with it from our first rehearsal.
Georgia, sing our leading lady's opening number.
Which song is this?
It's the one with the new lyric that Georgia wrote about me.
About? Rob Hood.
Precisely. Aaron, play. Georgia, sing. Jenny, put her in Light Q5.
Light Q5? This is silly, okay? I haven't sung on a stage in years.
Just sing.
Thinking of him. Thinking of him. Sometimes it seems I spend every moment of my waking day thinking of him, making him laugh, sometimes making him strong, sometimes making him feel someplace in the light is his, telling him just how special he is. Thinking of him. Thinking of him. Telling the truth when nobody's willing to tell him the truth. Fighting for him. Living for him. Thinking it over. That's what I think I'll do. Well, isn't it time? Isn't it high time? I was thinking of me.
Allow Jessica Cranshaw to sing it. Now look here, everyone.
I think it's a damn shame our leading lady collapsed at tonight's performance. She might have done it weeks ago and saved us a month of misery. But the cavity that Jessica has created must be appropriate for you.
May I speak? As Jessica's understudy, I feel terrible taking over under these circumstances.
No need to feel terrible, Nikki. No need, because you're still going to be the understudy to Georgia.
Georgia, the best idea you've ever had?
You know the Scorn script better than anyone else. You sing the songs from your heart because it's where the words came from. And I realize it's been quite some time since you've traded in your cap shoes for rhyming dictionary, but...
Excuse me. But speaking for those of us in the cast, I really think Nikki should get the part. She's talented and dedicated.
And since you're Nikki's understudy, if she gets the lead, you get her part.
Yes, that too.
Nice try, Bambi. But either Georgia is it, or I'm out.
What do you say, Oscar?
Chris, I'll put my money where your mouth is.
Laundered first. Ellen, I assume there's more than meets with your...
No, to be honest, it doesn't.
Oh, man.
Thanks for the vote of confidence.
I have my reasons.
You always have.
Besides, this entire debate is pointless if Jessica shows up tomorrow.
Oh, God help us. Her performance was worse than ever this evening.
Jessica Cranshaw will never be any better than she was this evening.
But she was horrible.
I know, but she'll never be better. She's dead. That was the hospital on the phone. In terms of future performances, Jessica Cranshaw now has a conflict. What happened? They wouldn't tell me.
Chris. Do you want to say something to the company about Jessica?
Well, shall we observe a minute of silence to match the audience's response to Jessica's first number?
Chris!
Well, all right. Let's all form a semicircle. Boy, girl, boy, girl. Oh, dear heavens. Tallest on the inside. Oscar, please.
Yes.
Much better. No, Ben, you're blocking the entire right side of the house. People, Jessica was part of our company, and now we part company. But I'm sure we'll all remember her in our thoughts and in our resumes. And as thespians I know, you would all like to display your sorrow as both a tribute and as an acting exercise. Sasha, see you mine now.
She read no books.
it's an honor to be standing on the same stage with each and every one of you.
We're kind of in the middle of something here.
Sorry.
Longs to be in
song. And though your analyst may never couch it that way, you don't know how lucky you are. Some policemen and detectives dream of show business, but they can't get arrested, but still they sit around the station and fancy this life. They cheer Sherlock Holmes and cheer back the night.
Ask your cleaning lady, don't you dream of show business to vocalize and stretch beside a board.
Her affirmative shrug as she shares your rug lets you know.
Special kind of all-rounder show person, just as the next waiter you meet.
He walks in creepy voices, his voice is just rap.
He gives you the check, you give him a hand.
If the boys in valet parking turn to show business, they could scout a higher ticket for your car.
At my tree surgeon now, started taking.
Friends as Lefty.
How
mean, that just went... I mean, wow.
Gee, for a second I was impressed, as I once told my husband at the hotel tab. Come on, what do you say we all go across the street and have ourselves one slobber knocker of a wait for the late, if less than great, Jessica Cranshaw? Drinks are on me!
I'm sorry, but this theater is quarantined. All the exits are guarded, and none of you can leave. No, I'm sorry. The entire company and crew will be living right here in the theater until further notice. Emergency services will bring in cots and meals.
I'm sorry, but the talented members of this cast are entitled to a day off.
The talented members and even you, Elaine!
Listen, listen. Tell me if I'm wrong here, but to the best of my recollection, Jessica Cranshaw never left the stage during the show's last 10 minutes. If so, then I'm very sorry, but she had to have been murdered by one of you. I've never had a case with this many suspects, and I can't have each of you followed around the clock. Better I keep you all under lock and key until I solve this crime.
You're taking the law into your own hands, Choppy.
Well, yeah. That's sort of what I'm made to do. I mean, that's why I have the badge and my own gun. Oh, all right, anyway. Being sequestered here will let you focus on fixing the show.
Fixing?
Get your damn off here!
Who's that?
Sounds like my husband, on his best behavior.
I guess he left New York.
Lucky New York!
Well, isn't this just peachy keen? He all waited up for me.
Jake!
He's still wearing my coat.
Sorry.
Sydney, it's been a god-awful night.
I hear you, Chris.
And I'm turning in my resignation.
I can't hear you, Chris.
Ah, Oscar, how are you holding up?
Well, can't play.
That's right, you can't.
Welcome back to Boston, Sydney.
Oh, well.
Hello.
Oh, it's me, Sydney, your stepdaughter.
Oh. Oh, sorry. Fawn?
The name is Bambi.
Well, last of the least, Mrs. B, my junior partner and lesser half.
All right, let's get this over with, Sydney.
What? You expect me to be upset? I left you in charge of opening night, and I returned to find a murdered leading lady, deadly reviews, and a bunch of cops who tell me I can't leave this theater!
I'm afraid you've arrived at just the wrong time for you, and just the right time for me, Mr. Bernstein.
Excuse me?
Lieutenant Frank Choppy. Now listen, folks, you should all go about your various tasks, just as if this weren't the scene of a homicide. Detective McNichol is waiting downstairs for your pertinent information. I'd like each of you to give him your name, address, and 8x10 glossary. I'll be speaking with all of you in the morning. Pleasant dreams, everyone.
I was in Manhattan when Jessica was murdered.
Can you prove that?
Well, it, so happens I was, keeping company with a, young actress I happened to be, keeping on Sutton Place. If I give you her name, it could ruin her reputation.
Your chivalry is touchingly convenient.
Lieutenant, I have many influential friends in New York City!
Too bad you're in Boston.
And will you be wanting me any further, Lieutenant?
No. But I do have some questions for your boyfriend.
I don't have a boyfriend.
Actually, Miss Harris, I'd like to take you into my confidence regarding this investigation.
Why is that, Lieutenant?
Well, because if I don't, there's really no reason for us to keep talking.
Then take me into your confidence with confidence, Lieutenant.
Something's very wrong here. I just met an opening night cast who all seemed incredibly eager to close.
Well, I can understand how they might feel. They all gave up wonderful jobs and hit Broadway musicals to work up here in Boston. I've never performed outside of this city, and Bambi's had to fight her mother at every step just to be in the chorus. But the rest of the cast are underpaid and overworked, though surely not enough to drive any of them to murder.
Keep in mind, I'm within arm's reach at any hour of the day or night.
You think I'm in some danger?
No, that was a completely unrelated thought.
You live with danger on a daily basis, don't you, Lieutenant?
Oh, mostly it's just paperwork and procedure. Detectives have no opening night, Miss Harris. We make our entrance after the curtain has fallen on someone else's life.
But it's a calling, isn't it? Like a doctor or a teacher?
Or an actor.
I suppose you're right. I can't imagine doing anything else with my life. It's not wrong to be married to one's work, is it?
No. Not at all. But sometimes it's no honeymoon. I love my job. I really do. And if I say so myself, I'm good at it too. I catch the bad guys most of the time. So it's a good life. A perfectly good life. Not exactly sublime. When I finish my work and I crawl into bed, I reflect as I turn out the light that the day that's to come and the week that's ahead will be lunch counter mornings and coffee shop nights. Lunch counter mornings and coffee shop nights.
It's reassuring to have such a dependable schedule, like matinees every Wednesday.
Or brisket and broad beans each Thursday.
With your friends.
Ashwa. I like my pals. The guys on the force. We're not very social. They're unmarried, of course. Sometimes we go bowling or have a few beers. So it's a fine life, a perfectly fine life. I'd give it 2 cheese. But sometimes I think at the end of the day, when I've read the last burglar his rights, that the life that I lead is a little bit gray, with its lunch counter morning.
But your acting roles, don't they make for a change?
Oh, Miss Harris, each year from May 23rd to the 12th of June, when I turn my life over to the Swallow Street Players, that's more than a vacation for me. It's an overture of hope, with the curtain rising and the greatest joy of my life. But the rest of the year, the life that I lead, is a little bit gray. There are plenty of gray days and not many hours. Mostly lunch counter mornings and coffee shop nights. I don't mean to sing forward, but might I walk you home?
I'd be delighted, but you said we're not allowed to leave.
Damn.
Traveler!
Excuse me! Lieutenant Frank Chaffee! Mind telling me who you are? you are and how you got in here?
Oh, as a member of the press, I'm exempt from your quarantine, Lieutenant Daryl Gray of the Boston Globe.
After the review you gave Robin Hood, I can't imagine why you'd show your face here of all places.
I'm as mystified as you. The show's producers called and asked me to pay a visit.
That's right. Harmon Bernstein, Mr. Brady. You have our thanks for coming by, and not for your review.
Listen, I tried my level best to say something good about your production. I praised your choreography and that young woman that plays a school mom, Nikki
Harris.
Well, I'm afraid it's all history now. My condolences on the loss of your star and your show.
When you interviewed me last week, I told you we were going to Broadway no matter what you wrote about us.
Robin Hood is staying open, and once we've ironed out the kinks, we're asking you to review it again with Georgia Hendricks in the lead.
Georgia Hendricks? Your lyricist? She hasn't been in the show in years. That's some story, and yes, there is precedent to rephrasing a show with a new lead. All right, tell you what, I'll review your show tomorrow night.
Tomorrow?
Keep in mind, to be fair, keep in mind, not many shows can survive two bad reviews from the Globe in 1 week.
Carmen, will you please go tell the cast and crew that we have 24 hours, some little week of rehearsals? If we fail, you'll live to regret it!
Sydney, I guess the reason you're such a lowlife is because they built you so close to the ground. Good day, Lieutenant.
You've just made it one of the servants.
Ooh, Nikki, that dress goes great with your eyes.
Thank you. And I can't believe it. Mr. Daryl Brady, am I allowed to offer my thanks for the kind words you wrote?
Please don't misunderstand me, Sarah. I try not to fraternize with artists I review. But let me say, you did stand out in what was otherwise an abundantly misguided production.
But Mr. Grady, I thought your review of Robin Hood was needlessly cruel and way off the mark.
Well, I'm not sure you know how to judge acting, Lieutenant.
Of course, you're the expert. Although I regret to inform you that I'm now placing you under arrest for the crime of murder.
What?
Any statement you make may be taken down in writing and used against you in a court of law.
This is insane! What in God's name are you saying?
I'm saying my best lies from Agatha Christie's murder at the Vicarage. I played Chief Inspector Slack for the Native Town Players 2 summers ago. Oh! I'm sorry, did you think I was saying that for real? Gosh, I'm not sure you know how to judge acting, Mr. Grady. Where you going?
Grady! I'll lock you at the door.
Swell acting, Lieutenant. And not just on a community theater level. I mean college.
Thank you.
And how is your investigation coming along, if I may ask?
I've been going over the show's financial records. And you know, you were right. Everyone here is working for the same equity minimum. Not just your newcomers like you and Bambi, but your stars as well. Look, this is no place for us to talk. Let's you and I get out of here for a little while.
Won't let me leave.
Damn!
Lieutenant! You must clear the stage immediately! I've just been informed I have less time to reinvent this show than Moses had to cross the Red Sea, and he had God on his side.
Is this true?
I'm getting reviewed tomorrow?
Nikki, go fetch Bambi. I've no choice but to re-block in the same boat here and now.
Oh, I'm going to have to watch this.
Why? Do you think something's going to happen?
No, I just really like this number. Although...
What?
It's nothing, but I don't
know. What?
I can't believe I'm about to say this and shoot me with my own gun if I'm...
What is it?
I don't think simply changing the choreography is going to help. The song itself is kind of lackluster. It lacks...
Yes?
Luster. Three women on the Arkansas River in a rowboat that's sinking fast, trying to get to the federal courthouse in Wichita before the farmers lose their land. Great stuff! It's your 11 o'clock number! But the music itself is, I wonder, could we hear a bit of it?
Sasha? Ladies, sing for the lieutenant, will you?
In the same boat, on the same sea, shaking inside as the tide keeps rising. Nary a ship, nary a sail, nary a soul on the whole horizon. Still we are not discouraged due to the ancient good legend likely to win. Take it all on the chin when you're in the same boat.
Sort of mild men.
Strangely enough, I agree.
in a completely new composition, one that's catchier than Pink Eye.
Oh, you want a hit?
Yes, not some song from one of your failed shows either, Evan. None of your Planet Planet trunk music?
Listen, Chris, if you want me to come up with anything, you'll have to find me a little bit of private time with my piano and my writing partner.
Your writing partner is now my dancing partner and the star of this show. If she doesn't get the saloon number under her belt tonight, we're all finished.
And I need to see that very number in full dress regalia this instant. Jenny, tell the cast to change for the act one finale from Funabar's At Bar in the Barbie Bar Saloon.
Say again.
I can't say that again.
Mr. Belling's rehearsal takes priority, so those of you who need to change costume, go ahead. As for the rest of you, please proceed to the green room where Detective O'Farrell will be fingerprinting the entire company. That is, unless one of you would be kind enough to explain why you committed murder. So let's clear the stage and give our composer the solitude he needs. That should give you a few minutes alone with your piano, Mr. Fox.
Yeah, alone.
Must be quite a challenge, having to create when your writing partner is,
Otherwise engaged?
Could I ask, only because I've wondered this my entire life, what would normally come first, the music or the lyric?
Well, the same answer as the chicken and the egg.
Ah, so it's the lyric.
No! A great melody doesn't need a lyric.
Or a lyricist.
Well, then how do you start?
Well, it can start with a note, which can turn into a phrase. And you try hanging words off each branch, like trimming a tree.
Sounds easy enough.
Really? Well, don't talk about love, 'cause then you'll have to say, it's like a glove, or as certain as push comes to shove, you'll pine for the woman you're constantly thinking of. You see the problem?
Dangling parts. So you suggest staying away from love?
At all costs. And don't mention your life. Or else you'll have to say, cuts like a knife, or as certain as the heartbreak and strife, when you feel like you're missing your...
Missing?
What?
You were saying what you miss.
I miss the music. I miss the song. When she's not with me, it comes out wrong. It doesn't matter how hard I try. I've lost the music. I don't know why.
I miss the music. I miss the music I made with love. I liked the music I made with...
Oh, sorry, am I interrupting?
No, I'm afraid I'm the guilty party there. But thank you, Mr. Fox, for all the insights. Ms. Hendricks, best of luck in your upcoming number. We'll speak later.
I forgot my lyric. Can you believe it? Me!
Well, you're not the lyricist now. You're the star. How does it feel being back on the boards?
Terrifying. Thrilling. I've missed...
You missed?
...the stage.
Oh. Come on, Angel. We gotta do that way right away.
Must we?
It's our last chance to land the number before we pack it in for the night. Here we go, honey.
Oh, Aaron, I'm thinking you were right when you said I was wrong for this.
Georgia. Break a leg.
Thanks. You can finish the song without me?
I'm a one-man band.
Thank you. see you dance and holler Attaway!
Attaway!
Here you go. to all of you. Made a few phone calls, and what do I come up with? A murder victim named Jessica Cranshaw, working for a fraction of her usual firm salary. A distinguished director who despised the late Miss Cranshaw, yet toils to make this show work all the same. A dancer choreographer who turned down the chance to work with Balanchine to do a song and dance for spare change. Ex-partners in marriage and in music who inexplicably reunite, though they no longer work in harmony. A one-man bank named Oscar Shapiro, who despite having no prior interest in theater, sinks one payment after another into this show. A company who celebrates when the show is torn to ribbons by the critics, because this means that they are at long last free to take better jobs back on Broadway. What does this tell me? That Sid Bernstein was blackmailing every member of this company into working on this show. Even you dancers?
Okay, so when I was starting out, I gave Sid Bernstein a private audition that I hoped would stay private.
Gross. What about you chorus boys? You all seem like clean-cut fellas. What could all of you have possibly done that you wouldn't want the folks back home to know?
Lieutenant, I have to think that everyone has something about themselves that they'd like to keep to themselves.
Agreed. But I'm not here to uncover all your dark secrets. Just the one that caused someone to murder Jessica Cranshaw.
People, I had no idea this was how Sidney got you all to work so cheap. He's the one who handles negotiations.
Well, he won't be able to deal his way out of breaking the law. Ladies and gentlemen, you won't be blackmailed anymore.
That's all.
You're all still suspects. Now get to work. You may have joined the show for the wrong reasons, but you're going to press on. Because you have a contract.
Damn straight.
Because Oscar deserves a return on his investment.
Thank you.
And because for the best way for me to solve Jessica's murder is to keep the heat turned up in this pressure cooker of a theater. And lastly, because this could be a really good show.
Very good. Sir, company.
Heads up, we're striking the set.
What? No, Jenny, I'm not finished. You still have yet to set up pose.
Sorry.
Well, all right. Let's have the last four balls. Bobby. A 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Thank you.
isn't it? I mean, it's almost like a hobby over there.
Yeah. If I had to bet, I'd say he did it.
Oh.
He did it, I'm sure.
Look familiar? Each page has the name of a company member, along with a notation in Bernstein's personal secret code. Obviously, a memo of why each of you were being blackmailed.
No! Meaning, no, I wasn't being blackmailed, but also meaning, no, I've just got more death threats. I'm afraid they're covered with my fingerprints once again.
That's all right, Miss Harris. You've already proven yourself to be forthcoming and trustworthy and just so very nice.
Well, thank you.
Dear Sydney, end the show or it's the end of you.
Oh my God, Sid Bernstein died for nothing. He told me he was gonna close the show.
When did he tell you that?
Well, in his office, right before he got hoisted. He said that someone in just that moment changed his mind about keeping Robin Hood open, and I should save my money for his next big Boston show. Then he went upstairs to watch Georgia rehearse her big number. He gave me back the very last check I ever wrote him.
You can give that to me, Oscar. I'm not closing this show. Now come on, let's go put that check in a safe place.
It's so safe in my pocket.
Lieutenant, what's the matter?
It's been troubling me since yesterday. I mean, why is it that Bobby,
what?
I mean, of all the people on this stage.
All right, Lieutenant, spit it out.
You ought to be in the Fort Henderson Square Dance number.
Beg pardon?
You'd stop the show. After all, wouldn't Rob Hood go to the big picnic with St. Louis Sue?
It makes sense.
Dancing.
Exactly.
Bobby, can you improvise a short turn in time for tonight?
Sure, but I don't know if I can make the costume change in time.
For gosh sakes, Bobby, it's just losing a bandana and putting on a mask. Would it kill you to try?
We'll time it out now. Jenny, the Fort Henderson Square Dance number.
The Fort Henderson Square Dance!
Now we're getting somewhere. Oh, and Aaron, we've got to have that rewrite you promised of in the same boat.
I already wrote it.
Without me?
Yeah, how did we rehearse it last night while you were getting good?
To be honest, I thought it turned out pretty well.
Well, can I hear it?
Sure.
I changed it to Rob Hood and his men heading up the mighty Colorado. You know, for real.
Ready, arm, approach.
Sasha, a quick chorus of In the Same Boat.
If you just wrote it last night, what are the musicians?
I wrote a brand new melody for the old orchestra box.
I think we understand.
Here we are, my shipmates and me, lost on a windy sea. All the planks are spread a leak. We'd like to bail, but we're not the bailman. We regret to say our compass has gone, but somehow we still say.
I'm going to put
same boat in the dry dock for the time being.
Please, Erin, come back
when you have a new song.
Thank you for the chance, Mother. It's called Giving You Enough Rope to Hang Yourself, Elaine. Maybe not my best words.
Why do you always make fun of me in front of other people?
Perhaps I should leave.
No, you have dreams of being in theater. Choppy, you should hear this too. Elaine, as a Broadway producer, there's something worth far more to me than you getting a star turn.
What?
Me. Turning a profit. I've never been known as one of those stupid clocks. Elaine.
Bambi.
Who hisses away a lot of her hard-earned bucks. Elaine.
Bambi.
But facing the fact your coloratura sucks. Bambi. Though it breaks your mother's heart, forget about the part. It's time for you to know why I really backed this show. You ask me for my motives, well, you needn't be so smart. It's a business. It isn't making history, it isn't making art, it's a business.
Theaters don't need to turn a buck. That's not business.
That's not business.
So give Melissa Strata and I wish him lots of luck. I do business. Attention, Nuno Val. business when I say that you're not star material, Elaine. That's my opinion, and I don't care who knows it.
Well, I think my dance number could be very provocative.
Sweetie, the only thing you could arouse is suspicion.
Of course, the company's ready for the square dance.
Enjoy beyond my wildest dreams.
Oh, may I?
And Carmen, how many more hours do we have before we are re-reviewed?
My dear old great of the Boston Globe.
Great ass. Not what I expected. Then never actually seen a picture of you.
Complete anonymity is a critic's best tool.
Well, I suppose I shouldn't bite the hand that slaps me, but it's unethical to review opera at rehearsal.
You forget, I report on theater for the Globe as well as review it. Your show's news, and I'm setting aside my customary professional distance to interview members of your company down in the green room. With your permission, Mrs. Bernstein.
Free publicity, Carmen.
Poor Sydney. He would have died to get this much press. And he did! The green room is yours, Brady.
Carton!
Company! The Fort Henderson Square Dance Number. Bambi auditioning a new section with Bobby.
This I've got to see!
Keep all your fingers crossed.
So, let's follow the yellow lit road in the wrong direction. All the way back to Kansas Land. Sasha, yee-haw.
The women folk head out from town to greet the soldiers here.
We greet them on the field!
Yeah, that's obviously Cher.
Ain't no chance for romance, the dance is strictly square.
In Kansas Slam, it's strong and never strange. Cause in Kansas Slam, you can't be too good in the head. In Kansas Slam, don't shake that sound surprise. Cause in Kansas Slam, there's lots of splendor in that crowd.
About when Adam found himself alone with Eve. Or no preacher present when a game has made a world. Yet where we be if Eve had not been that kind of girl?
In Kansas land, where fairy meets the sky. In Kansas land, ain't no finer place to live and die. In Kansas land, your virtue never fades. Cause in Kansas land, we're always sure to pull the strings.
Then this St. Louis woman knocking at the door. A former farmer's daughter guessing up and hopped on tour. At first, the mountain cavalry thought she was hot to trot. She kicked back out rock, put the tie to her tie tonight.
Thank you.
out, including whoever fired that shot. Bobby?
I'm bleeding.
Looks like it's just a crease wound. Did anybody see anything?
No.
Bobby, how many people knew you'd be leaping when you did?
Well, nobody. I was trying it for the first time. That was some fancy shooting.
Too fancy. Unless you weren't the person they were trying to shoot. Everybody but Bobby, go back to where you were when the shot rang out. You folks! Stay right here.
Hold on, aren't we all sitting ducks here? Right.
Whoever fired that shot had plenty of time to fire again if they didn't mind getting caught. Back to your places. Guys, the sparrow is here?
Yeah.
Here's where the bullet entered and exited. It grazed Bobby, but may have been intended for you, Randy. Why aren't you wounded?
I am. Deep down. You could ask him why.
Are you usually standing here at this point in the number?
Well, no. When Bobby jumped, I moved here to give him room.
And most likely you weren't the target either. So still following its path, the bullet must have been aimed at you.
Pinky?
You were here when Bobby was shot?
I'm not sure. Is that important?
Well, if you were here, you couldn't very well shot it yourself, and I could rule you out as the killer.
You hadn't ruled me out already, Lieutenant.
Wait a second. Bobby, you're holding that handkerchief against your left arm.
Well, it's bleeding.
But that's impossible. If the shot came from out there, and you were leaping with your right side to the audience, there's no way the bullet could graze the left side of your left arm. Guys, wasn't the skull and crossbones facing the audience?
Oh, yeah, I guess you turned around the wrong way.
Oh, come on. Yes, so it's exactly the opposite. The bullet was fired from behind the shot, hit Bobby at the end of his leap, went through the barrel on its way to... you.
Me?
Yep. And here's the bullet.
But that would mean the shot was fired...
by somebody on the stage or behind that singer. Folks who are off stage, were you with anybody? So the only people who couldn't have fired the shot were Carmen and Sasha. Because you're downstage, and Sasha is... well, you know. But don't you think Bobby should play his dance much further downstage?
I was planning to have the same idea.
Right, well, I'm afraid we'll have to search everybody for a gun.
There won't be any need for that!
She did it!
She did it! She did it! She did it! That begins for being slayer!
Nikki? What are you doing with that?
I found it back there! It's an automatic, so I guess it can't be a prop in our Western story. At least, I won't be leaving any fingerprints on the evidence this time. There's tape wrapped around the handle and... Trigger! Gosh, I might have killed you, Frank.
Hand me the gun very slowly, Nikki.
Something to say for whichever one of you tried to knock me off? Knock it off! Lieutenant?
Yes, Jenny?
We're way overdue for a break.
Sorry.
Back into everyone, we're clearing the set. Shocking. You're gonna protect me, right? There's already been two murders committed on the stage.
Three, if you count the integrity of musical theater!
You couldn't be surrounded by more police than you are at this moment, Mrs. Bernstein.
Come on, Mother. You should get something to eat. If you're nervous, I'll taste the food for you.
You have no taste, Elaine. I've seen your makeup, your closet, and your boyfriend's. And I've seen a couple of your boyfriends in the closet with your makeup.
You never have a good word to say about me, do you? I thought I did pretty good in that last number.
Huh. Big deal, considering the 15 years of ballet, jazz, and circus training I paid for. My professional opinion is you just don't have what it takes. You dyed your hair, changed your name. Why, of all the names on earth, would you pick Bambi?
Because in the movie, Bambi's mother is shot to death by the hunters.
Well, somebody just tried to do that to me, sweetheart. And I notice nobody's ruled you out.
No.
Come on, Oscar. I've got the keys to the lobby bar. I'll fix us some Bloody Marys.
Well, despite what your mother says you were great in that Kansas Land number.
Lieutenant, I really appreciate that.
No, I'm the one who should be thanking you.
Bambi, your dance really was good.
Yeah, better than I could have imagined, kiddo.
Well, it's just like I told you, Bobby. Just give me a chance and I won't let you down. And don't pay any attention to what your mother says. At least, no one can claim that you're in this show because of nepotism.
I guess that's pretty obvious.
Believe me, Lieutenant. Bambi isn't a girl in this cast who used personal connections to help her career.
What do you mean by that?
Sorry. Stage manager is equal part psychiatrist, mother hen, and father confessor. What anyone in this cast shares with me, I consider privileged information. Besides, what I know, Lieutenant, I don't think you want to.
Oh, there you are, Georgia. Oh, Aaron. Good. Could I talk to the three of you about Bernstein's Little Black Book of Black Men? He wrote a page about every cast member with three noteworthy exceptions. You, you, and you. Going by this book, Bernstein had nothing on you. Yet the production budget tells us you're working for the same raw deal as everyone else. Why are you toiling for pennies when you could be doing so much better elsewhere? No one has anything to say.
Can you blame us? I mean, if I recall, one of those death threats said, make another sound and you'll end up underground.
Exactly. But Georgia, I never read that particular death threat out loud.
What?
Nikki and the late Jessica Cranch are the only cast members who saw. Other than the person who sent it, of course.
But, well, then I guess Nikki told
you. I told her not to tell anyone.
I didn't, Frank. I told you I wouldn't, so I didn't.
Then, I'm sorry, Georgia, I have no choice but to book you on suspicion of murder.
What are you saying?
Nikki, do you think you'd be able to go on tonight?
I think
I could. Okay.
Oh, now I get it. You want to give a little boost to your sweetheart's career, huh?
My relationship with Nikki Harris is purely that of police investigator and possible suspect.
No, it's not.
It's not?
No, I really like you, Frank.
Oh, it's reciprocal, I assure you.
I'm very glad to hear that.
I'm more than glad. I was doing something.
Arresting me for murder?
Yes! It makes perfect sense. Please don't forget what we were saying. Jessica Cranshaw's death gave you the chance to star on Broadway. And when Sid Bernstein decided to close the show in Boston, his death kept your chance alive. Miss Hendricks, you'll have to come with me.
Wait a second, Lieutenant! I'm the one you want.
You're confessing to the murders, Mr. Fox?
You heard what I said.
That's not a simple thing to retract.
Think about what you're doing.
I have. This is a great thing that's happening in your life. I'm not important now.
Very noble. Yet you're on record as being dead set against Georgia taking this role.
I just said that because I knew if she took the role, she wouldn't have time to write with me, be with me. That's how Sydney got me to work for nothing. It was the only way I knew to be near her again. Stuck out of town together, huddled around a piano each night. Who knows what happened?
That's how Sydney got me to work on the show, Aaron. I wanted the same thing.
You did?
I do.
But you and Bobby.
No. You two, forget that.
I don't understand.
I didn't want you to. Not until I knew for sure how you felt, but you seemed as preoccupied as ever with
because
your
music. Because our songs were the only place where you and I were still together.
Aaron, you said our songs.
Our songs are like... What was I thinking when I let you slip away? Oh yeah, I was thinking of me. Only of me. What was I thinking, spending each moment of my waking day thinking of me? The shutting you out,
sometimes
making you wait,
sometimes
how I do need you. But why pretend I miss the music? I miss the
joke's on me.
Lieutenant, I hereby officially unconfess everything except being fooled.
Aaron, our director needs to see you on the double.
I'm excused.
Go.
See you downstairs, partner.
Partner.
Thank you, Lieutenant. You play your part very effectively.
Oh, and what a treat to share a scene with you. And in a fair exchange, you got Aaron to show you his cards. I got the reason why you both came on board with this show.
You and Georgia staged all that?
Yes, it was her idea. A good one, I thought. But you've been playing a part too, haven't you, Bobby?
I plead guilty to impersonating Georgia's devoted lover.
When rehearsals first started, I asked if Bobby would pretend we were involved again to see if I could stir up something, anything in Aaron.
Good job.
Thank you, Bobby. I'm so grateful.
A polite reminder, you're still suspects.
Right.
Bobby, I may have found out why Aaron and Georgia work for Sidney Bernstein, but I still don't know your reason.
I always wanted to get the performance of a lifetime.
Fooling Aaron by acting as if you're in love with Georgia?
No. Fooling Georgia that I'm acting. There's nothing I won't do for me.
Except commit murder?
Even that, if she asks me.
Oh, Frank. Why does love make so many people feel bad? The public should be warned that Cupid is armed and dangerous.
Maybe romance should be left strictly in the hands of the police.
If you mean present company, I vote yes on that proposition.
Oh,
please call me Frank. I mean, please call me Frank.
May I be bold?
I already know you are.
I never believed in that whole some enchanted evening thing until now. The first time I saw you, there was a blue wash on the stage, and they hit you with a pink special. It was,
It was just like a musical, huh, Frank?
I thought, well, Nikki, I thought to myself, you and I, we could be a tough act to follow. Can't you see special people doing special things? Running rings around anywhere, anywhere.
Frank. Hey, Harry, put him in pink!
Marge and get our champion.
Me too! Isn't that incredible? Both of us having the exact same fantasy at the exact same time!
Marge and Gower champion.
In your fantasy, which one was up?
Gower.
Me too! And the song we were singing?
Would make for a great opening number.
No, actually, more like a finale.
That's perfect too!
Would you like to go out?
You won't let me.
I keep forgetting. And I can't make any exceptions, even though you're exceptional.
Oh, Frank, from the moment I first shook your hand, I had a feeling that
Shook your hand?
What?
Shook your hand. Nikki, I think it's time you told me what Sid Bernstein had on you.
Nothing. Really. Unlike the rest of the cast, I want to be in the show. I've gotten some wonderful reviews here in Boston, but this is the best chance I've ever had at Broadway.
Jenny hinted that a woman in the cast used some secret personal connection to advance her career, and that I wouldn't like knowing who she was. Did she mean you?
Every show is filled with gossip.
Oh, Nikki, you didn't say no. Who is it?
I made a promise to someone that I wouldn't talk about it. I don't break promises.
You know, in Bernstein's notebook with the coded messages about each person's secret, next to your name, he wrote a great big zero.
I'm glad.
Maybe it was the letter O.
Oscar, the sandwich you ordered is here! For crying out loud, Nikki, you have to get into your costume.
Sorry.
Folks, in 5 minutes, we're back on stage to learn and block yet another brand new version of In the Same Boat. Thanks, guys.
Jenny, if Nikki
should... Don't talk near the microphone, Lieutenant. When it's switched on, everybody downstairs can hear you.
Tell me now what you know about Nikki Harris.
In what capacity are you asking that question? Officer of the law, jealous boyfriend. Can what I say be held against me, or will you hold it against me if I don't say what you want to hear?
I have finished questioning the cast, and I'm not finished with you.
Whatever you're playing, it's not from the score of this show.
Come in, my sweetheart. Come in.
Who's there?
Don't be afraid. I won't let you.
Look, this is no time to be joking. We've already had two people die.
Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to put a fright into you.
Give us a hand, will you?
Trying to catch poor Ophelia here. You know this theater for eons, apparently. Just a mouth into the pit. Stuck with the percussion instruments. I'll put in a basket in the green room. Yes.
Ben, I'm set here. Take five.
Q-59. Drop in planet Earth.
Got away from Martini's director, did you, Ophelia? Come here, pussy kitten. Don't be afraid. Oh, that's funny. I thought you were...
Hey, if you're worried, I'm going to tell anybody what I know about you and the murder.
Her bloodstains on the stage tell us she dragged herself over to get her call. and ripped out this one page on which she'd written the words, drop in planet Earth.
Well, drop in is simply the term we use for scenery, lowered from up here on the catwalk.
Exactly. Mountain drops in, skyline drops in.
Mary Martin drops in.
There's a drop of Earth at the end in the same boat.
There will never be an end to in the same boat. Listen, they're rehearsing the latest version now. St. Bloody Orchestra, our third new melody. Take the entire series.
My God! My God, that's it, I've solved it! We have to get down from here, fast!
This way, straight after me.
Frank, are you coming?
You get started. I'll be right along.
Be careful, Frank. The killer may realize we're onto him.
Yes, but as long as I'm all the way up here, I really should check out what's written on the side of this drop. Planet Earth. Nikki? Gee, isn't it amazing how you can be totally stumped about something until suddenly it hits you? Ow.
Weary and torn, weary and
men from the shore to the rescue.
Waves are coming along, the sharks are stabbing along, the thunder's clapping along, you'll hear it roar. But there's no doubt the world will stay afloat, cause it's easy to win, take it all on the cheek when you're in the same boat.
Now the pals go rolling round the bend, while the ladies of the creek come sailing into view. Let's put it all together and run.
Killer, how do you
and on opening night came straight down the aisle with his own set of flowers, which hid both his face and something as simple as a pellet. He shot Jessica directly in the mouth with a capsule, and that's how your star was murdered in full view of you and your audience.
But then, that means we're all in the clear.
No. Not everyone was on stage at that moment, Mickey. Where were you, Mr. Belly?
Taking a walk alone, as you damn well know.
And Aaron, you said you were standing at the back of the theater?
Yes. And like every man on opening night, I was wearing a tuxedo.
And I'll swear I was standing with him the entire time with him.
Well, I'm sure you would. Oscar?
I was sitting in the back row of the orchestra with Carmen. I'm sure she would have noticed if I got out of my seat and headed up for the stage.
That's right.
So very right. One person alone has both the perfect opportunity and a powerful motive.
Ah, Chucky! Ow!
But if that's Bobby, who's this?
Your devoted admirer, Nicky. Determined to bring down the curtain on Robin Hood. Because if the show went to Broadway, you'd leave his sphere of influence forever. A sphere represented by a circle drawn in Bernstein's book. A sphere that was the clue Jenny gave us as she died. A planet called Earth. Or as Shakespeare put it, the Great Globe itself. The Boston Globe and its senior critic, Daryl Gray.
Careful, I don't ever want to see her face again.
Easy, Daryl.
Easy for you? You're going to marry her. Heard you say so in the House of Yang. She loves you. She never loved you.
Frank, I swear I didn't know.
But she does know you, Daryl, doesn't she? You shunned publicity. Your picture has never been taken. Yet yesterday, she tried to walk right up to you and shake your hand and thank you for the compliments you paid her.
I asked her not to tell anybody, so I could praise and proclaim her in my reviews.
He was just a friend, giving me advice. It was nothing more than that.
It was more than that to me! Nicky, I needed you to stay here so I could hail and guard you. But this infernal musical was going to New York no matter what I wrote about it. Sid Bernstein said
and
so.
And watching the shows and previews, you saw how to guarantee that Jessica Crenshaw would never go to Broadway. As a critic on opening night, you could rush out of your seat after the finale without any eyebrows being raised, retrieve a bouquet you had hidden in the lobby, and come straight back down the aisle as the ultimate showstopper.
Yes, I'm sure I just put Carmen and Sandra in the same way I posted closing notices for Jessica and Ginny. Wow, an imperfect performance. One of the moments of mistakes right from
Daryl! I see you're out of guns. How far do you think you can get from this theater without one?
Good point! Set your gun down for me! Boy, now!
Fine. Just don't hurt him.
Get back!
Daryl, I'm going to take Nicky away from you now.
Take one more step and you're dead.
Frank, don't!
Fine, you're dead.
In situations like this, I always unload the gun in my shoulder holster, and I take all the bullets, and I put them in this gun! Come here, Nicky! Daryl Grady, you're under arrest.
Oh, God, God! How can my life get any worse than this?
Detective O'Farrell!
The rights remain silent, and anything you say can and will be used against you.
Folks, since you're all witnesses to Mr. Grady's confession, I'll need you all to head down to the green room and give a brief statement. After that, there's only a few hours before your new opening night. Sasha, play them off, will you?
Bobby, you okay? You need some help?
I think... Okay, maybe I could use some help.
Well, it's just like I told you. Just give me a chance and I won't let you down.
You know, Chuffy, if Robin Hood doesn't hit, I have you to thank. You ever need a vested suit and a nice gabardine, just drop by my showroom. For you, Lieutenant, anything in the store, 10% off.
There it is.
Funny. Suddenly I feel a flock of butterflies coming out of hibernation in my stomach.
Well, luckily you can't go chasing those butterflies. There's very little time and lots of work for you both before tonight's curtain.
Yes, lots of unfinished business.
Before and after the show.
Any additional notes before we open the curtain, Lieutenant?
Actually, Chris, Nicky and I did have a dream about a new finale for the show.
I'm sure we'll be singing it in tune if you think that we should. Oh, and by the way, bravo, the great detective.
Bravo, the great director.
Frank, I didn't have a clue about Daryl Grady.
I had more than one, and it still took me a while to figure him out.
Now that the mystery is solved, is our engagement over?
Perhaps we can discuss that after tonight's show. There's this coffee shop where I'm on very good terms with the management.
Frank, we have a date.
Fine, Sasha. Thus for Daniel.
Another triumph, Lieutenant. I'll see you back at the station.
Great work, Toffee. You put life into a show that was dying, and now they'll put Brady away for life.
Well, I have plenty of help, especially from you.
Me?
You and your daughter. I told her how much she'd shown me in that square dance number of hers. She was great.
Better than great.
Aha! Finally to hear you say it! You had me as flim-flammed as everybody else. Until I saw how really good she was and turned to see the pride on your face as you watched her. You tell everybody, it's a business. But I, you're the stage mother of all time. You married Sid Bernstein, you put up with all his affairs and shady deals just to get your daughter onto the Broadway stage. But so that no one could ever accuse her of getting there on your coattails, you always belittle her talented public. Even if she hates you for it.
You can't let her know. I want her to think she got it all on her own.
You're amazing.
But how did knowing that help you catch Grady?
Oh, it didn't. I just explained why you killed your husband.
What? Grady killed my husband.
No, Grady killed Jessica and Jenny and tried to kill you because he wanted the show closed. That's exactly what your husband was going to do.
Well, then he was killed by someone who was blackmailing.
Oh, if that was the case, I think they would have taken his little black book with them. He must have told you he was closing the show.
He didn't tell me he was closing the show.
He told Oscar. Why wouldn't he tell you? You were his partner.
Because our partnership was over. He had himself a conniving little ingenue on Sutton Place, and I was out in the street.
So he didn't need you.
He didn't need anybody. Grady promised him rave reviews for his next three shows if he shut this one down now.
So he did tell you he was closing the show.
No!
Then how would you know the terms of a deal he made with Grady minutes before he died if you weren't the last person to see him alive?
He laughed at me! After all I had to take from him, he laughed at me in a lane like we were nothing. And I killed him!
Of course you did.
So, what happens to me now, Lieutenant?
On impulse, you lashed out at your unfaithful, blackmailing husband when he told you your daughter wouldn't get the chance for which you'd sacrificed everything. A good lawyer might get you a couple years on a reduced charge. A great lawyer might get you an all-expense-paid weekend in sunny San Diego. But you'll have to stand trial.
I understand.
Why don't we build up your daughter's part some more, add another song or two for Nikki, and maybe I don't solve your part of this mystery until after the show opens on Broadway.
You would do that? Oh, Frank, you give me that and I'll let you walk me out of this cast party at Sardi's straight to police headquarters.
I'll have you watch Night and Day until then.
I understand. But if the show goes to Broadway, what happens between you and Nikki?
Oh, there's always a spot in the NYPD for a Boston lieutenant who doesn't mind a cut in rank and pay.
Chuffy, you know what? I think you're one of us. We're a special kind of people known as show people.
We live in a world full of dreams. Sometimes we're not too certain what's false and what's real, but we're seldom in doubt about what we feel.
You tell it. Your experience with the salt and battery. I'm afraid Bobby may need some first aid. He's a bit wobbly on his feet after getting hit in the head by Grady.
Let me take a look at him.
We're only a few hours before the curtain goes up. I'm afraid he may not rise to the occasion.
Don't worry, Chris. The cry of places, everyone, is like smelling salts to any trooper. The sound of the orchestra playing its overture will be pure adrenaline. His aches will be bathed in the warmth of the spotlight. His spirits will be lifted by the hands of an adoring throng whose applause will sustain Bobby White at the very last scene of the Robin Hood.
Mm-hmm.
finally found myself a home, a place where I belong, keeping company with the people I care the most about.
You came to us a stranger, rid this place of crime, and gave us new hope in ourselves.
That's gonna be one tough act to follow.
Well, how's this? Would you be my lawful wedded wife, Miss Nancy?
Oh, yes, I will!